Approximately 270 years ago, a powerful explosion occurred at a volcano in what would later become the United States. As the ground unexpectedly exploded upwards in the middle of a barren volcanic landscape, more than 10,000 cubic meters of boulders were ejected upwards, reaching up to 1,673 feet or 510 meters above the ground. As these large projectiles were ejected at speeds of up to 280 miles per hour, a jet-like roar became audible, and due to the vast heights these less than a pound to multi-ton boulders were ejected to, they took a surprisingly long time to fall back to Earth. As pieces rained down across the next 16 seconds, hundreds of loud thuds were heard in rapid succession, with one 7.2 foot or 2.2 meter wide piece falling a whopping 1,600 meters or nearly a mile to the east, a whopping 18 seconds later. Simultaneously, a plume of ash rose high into the atmosphere, eventually reaching a height of 40,000 feet. Now, assuming you hadn't read the title of this video, you might immediately think that what I just described occurred at some volcano in Alaska, perhaps Augustine, or maybe even Mount St. Helens in Washington State. But instead, this explosion originated from a volcano infamously known for its non-explosive eruptions. Specifically, the most voluminous and tallest volcano on the planet if we are including its base on the seafloor, Hawaii's Mauna Loa volcano. Well, yes, almost all of Mauna Loa's historical eruptions, especially its more recent events, have been completely effusive. There have been repeated occasions where even larger blasts occurred in prehistoric times. In fact, if you were to hypothetically walk on the Ainapu Trail up to the summit caldera of Mauna Loa and then hike completely around its entire rim, you would find at least 5 distinct ejecta deposits from highly explosive events. While the oldest two of these eruption deposits are poorly constrained by age, its 3 youngest large-scale explosive eruption deposits were seemingly emplaced around the year 1080, 1120, and 1750. While these 3 deposits are fairly easy to explain, it becomes a bit more confusing when you realize the 2 older deposits lie 2 miles further to the southeast away from the caldera. There, along the Ainapu Trail, one of these deposits is tentatively dated to sometime before the 440 CE lava flow which buried a portion of the outcrop. Each of these deposits formed as a result of volcanic blasts which could either fit as a VEI-1 or VEI-2 explosive eruption, which presumably occurred at the initial stages of what would thereafter be a largely effusive eruption. These deposits mean that such unexpected explosive eruptions are likely to one day happen again at Mauna Loa, disrupting air traffic and possibly even sending debris onto a set of structures on the eastern rim of Mauna Loa's summit caldera. So, why did Mauna Loa produce such explosive eruptions? Well, if you look at a record of Mauna Loa's eruptions, you might be surprised to learn that there is indeed a pattern of the time of year when the start of eruptions that produce explosive activity at its summit versus those that do not. And that these months will correlate to not only the coldest temperatures of the year, but also when the heaviest precipitation occurs. My interpretation is that the level of the groundwater table around Mauna Loa's summit is an important factor. If, during an eruption, the level of magma suddenly drops below the water table due to a blockage, pressure will build up until the groundwater flashes to steam and explodes, producing an explosive event. This is far more likely to occur during periods when the water table is higher, although it could also occur if a crater lake forms in the vent of a prior eruption which is then intruded into by a subsequent eruption. As for the 2 explosive eruption deposits around Ain Apo Trail, I believe that these erupted from long-term weak spots that are now the site of outer caldera cracks. These cracks may have represented a dominant path for magma to occasionally erupt through before Mauna Loa's modern caldera formed due to a 174.8 square kilometer flank eruption around the year 650. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Elise Moore for upgrading their membership tier to this channel.